Welcome to RPR. In this video, we'll discuss about how to compare leased data in Power Automate. So if you don't know about Microsoft Power Automate leased creations and adding the detail into the details, please watch my previous video. This is a part 2 video where we are going to compare two leased value from Microsoft Power Automate and showcase on or display on message box. So here we have used two Excel file which contains some data that is having employee name and salary. In second, we have the similar type of column and row structure but some difference in value. So these two files, if you can see here, we have difference here. Let me mark that is this difference. Then you can see this X. File with minimized version. Let me mark this. You can see this is a difference. Second, this one is seen. This is again seen. Here we have a difference. No difference. Here we have a difference, so we'll mark this as well with a different color. This is a difference, then we have these three differences. Now we'll save this so that in after executions, we will have this difference available or we can compare it. So let me close this to file and for creation of list and adding the detail into Power Automate, please watch my previous video. I will also include the URL and description tab. So for comparisons, we have direct activity in Power Automate. We have to just search for leased and you will have all these options available for leased itself. So if you want to find common leased items, we will just drag and drop here. We have to specify the leased one value and leased two value. So both the values are available here. Now, once I will save this code and run the flow, we will get the difference value, or we can showcase here the intersected value or common value, which is present within these two Excel files. So I will run this flow and show you. This is adding the data into the list. Now we don't have the intersected value. Okay, this two informations and then this will close. It's not showing here, or maybe let's select range for one column and column A and value we can add 9. That's really fine. Here also let's see result. Save this. Let's execute it. Every time we reference record by key. So rather than showing this way, we have other method because this way it's not working for this one. So what we will do, we will just modify it here, and here we will set some variable. So which we can do it, variable set variable here 1, and what we'll set here is set row, specify 1 here, save it. We'll add the same row in this so that we can increase the value. So here we'll specify row as this, remove 1. In every inclusion or in every execution, what we'll do, we'll increase the variable with this. So variable here, we'll use row and increase by 1. Then we will get desired value. Here we have to generate x vector. Perfect. Exactly same thing. We will do it for the second one as well. So here we specify the row 2. Same thing. Even we can do it for column as well. So again we'll set 1 value, and after that we'll increase the variable. Then we will get a proper result. So here I'll specify row 2 and add increase by 1. After that, we will get the desired result. Arrow here, I did not change this value. Row 2, and we have proper result. So let's see and run the code. Now again, this will launch Excel file which contains data. This will read through each of the Excel data and add into the list. After that, this will go to the next loop and perform the same actions. Here we can see we have these differences. From Philip, RPA, and RPA, and of these are the common name which we have received within the Excel file, so that you can verify. So these are the common names which we have within the Excel file. After that, this will show all the these list 1 and list 2 value, and then this will close the Excel file. Second comparison, we want to do it. We want to find it out the differences between each of the list. So for that, we will use subtract list. So here we'll add subtract list variable, and for that we will add list 1 in one set, list 2 in second set, and we'll save into variable list reference. I want to disable this, or maybe we can enable it, and then we'll add on message box or display message. So here we'll select least to difference and then save it. Let's save this complete flow and run the code. Now this time again to launch the Excel file, code the Excel file, create a new list, set the variable, add all those informations into the list. Same thing to perform with second list, and then this will show us a difference. So John, Karen, Komal, and Kia is the difference which we can easily see, which we have highlighted with the blue color. So these are the differences which Power Automate found from the list, which we can use it anywhere. So you can easily see these differences are already there. So here we can see the difference name. Then here we have different name as well as salary. So this is how we can verify or take it out the differences of two least value from Excel, and these are the common names. Next is least 1 and the least 2 value, and then this will close the Excel file. So this is how we can compare these two lists using Microsoft Power Automate, which is much easier to perform any Excel. That's all about this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.